fair needs picking up from Starfish Island.
I only wish I could be around a little longer to enjoy it. I feel so old. Someone must take my legacy. I must train a little me.
How old are you?
I'm 23, but I feel much older and wiser. I know everything. I've seen a lot of the world.
What does the rest of the world have to tell us about how to do things? Build more trains? Have people elect their leader rather than an elite electoral college? Ride a bike to work like a Girl Scout? Or a clown with dietary concerns? No thanks, Vladimir.
I'll agree with that. People from other countries are good for nothing. That's why we have to keep teaching them a lesson. I'll tell you what makes a real man. A truck to pull stuff and a couch to think on.
I'll tell you. Speaking as a sensualist, and by that I mean a very narrow-minded, id-centered man of peace, who travel. I recently went to Europe. I think everyone should see it for a week. You're really wrong with this country when you visit a European utopia. Things like a journey, public transportation, healthcare, leather shorts, mustaches. When I went to Belize, I helped some villagers some land for an environmentally friendly coal mine. We've all got to make some...
This is my fare. Back off, asshole.
My dad gave me the money to set up an exciting trust there.
But how does that help the people in Vice City from worrying about whether they are gonna get robbed? What drives a man to just take?
What we need are more after-school sports like choir or drama so people can learn to express themselves properly by singing or pretending to be a tree. Have you ever heard of Renaissance? It's a lonely form of beauty in some very ancient wisdom. Helping people to help themselves with drama and choir and flowers and my dad's money.
Listen, trust fund, Tommy. Your ideas are pathetic. It's no wonder that mankind has woken up one day to find me in charge, amigo.
Mr. Strub, you got elected on a campaign promising to reduce taxes to zero. But under your stewardship, we've seen taxes go up by 20% and services decline.
Nobody is interested.
Come on, get it, quick. Okay, please, don't hurt me.
I shall not, I cannot stoop to your level. They assured me this was a show that understood politics, where we could debate things mano a mano. And I find myself having statistics hurled at me like so much stale confetti. We cannot boil people down to numbers. You have no idea, my friend, what it takes to serve, the sacrifices I've made to help my country, to help Vice City. The complexity of government, the hideousness of my wife, and the way her thighs grow like our national debt. Oh, sure, some people like that, but not me. It's a nightmare, my friend, and I'm thrown back at me by an ingrate like you. I can scarcely get up in the morning.
And with that outrageous revelation, let's take a quick break to tell you something very informative. You're listening to Pressing Issues on Vice City Public Radio. Over to you, Jonathan.
Hello and welcome back. I'm Jonathan Freeloader and you're listening to VCPR. This portion of Pressing Issues is brought to you by Ammunation, a proud supporter of public radio and our community. We hope you're enjoying Pressing Issues and the way it challenges your view of society. Unfortunately, public radio in Vice City is under pressure. That's because we're better than everyone. You can't hear this kind of hard-hitting, long, drawn-out programming anywhere else. But you have to give money.
That's right, Jonathan. Money is important. It can be exchanged for goods and services.